But first, a 5 on your side investigation that will leave you wondering, could this happen to me?
I want you to think about your home for a moment. Mm. Now think about losing your home because of a 25-cent mistake. Well, that could happen to a man in Warrensville Heights.
5 on your side investigator Jonathan Walsh has this exclusive investigation here where the Cuyahoga County Treasurer shows it's unwilling to see the absurdity of the man's case.
I was trying to catch up. I knew I was behind on everything.
It was no secret Jerome Montgomery owed back taxes on his modest condo. So in 2013, he set up a payment plan, $205 a month.
I've been paying for 5 years to get it down, so you know I'm paying to get it to where I needed to be.
He even showed us the records of his consistent payments over the years. And then in December of 2018, he picked up the phone to contact the Cuyahoga County Treasurer.
I'm thinking I'm done with the payment plan, so when I called her, she said I'm in default.
The county said he missed his September 2018 payment. So follow me here. In September, Jerome's account had $210.63. His payment was for $205.88. That left $4.75 in the account. The problem is, his account can't dip below $5. So the county rang it up as non-sufficient funds. And all of this is because of a quarter. So after the missed payment, there were all kinds of fees and interest added to Jerome's account, ballooning it to the point that he now owes thousands of dollars more. And on top of that, his property is in foreclosure.
It's confusing. I just don't understand why they just couldn't just let me repay the payment.
Cuyahoga County wouldn't go on camera with us. It says it's just following Ohio law. When a payment doesn't come through, the office doesn't know if the account is 25 cents short or $3,000 off. So it's now offering Jerome a payment plan on the new money he now owes.
My payments are $205 now. Now they saying I got to pay $1,005. So, I mean, I don't know. I got to live. I don't know.
Our research shows Ohio law states that if there is a missed payment, the county treasurer shall notify the taxpayer of such deficiency.
Nobody from the treasurer told me that I was in default.
The county says it did contact Jerome about September's missed payment. If that is the case, why would then Jerome put $205 in for October and November, thinking he was still paying down the debt?
It just don't seem fair.
I reached out to Jerome's credit union. No response. The county says it's not to blame, that the credit union and Jerome should have been better on top of this. We asked the county if sensible heads can come together and see what we're talking about here. 25 cents. But no one is budging.
If I'm a person that you paying for 5 years and I see you made a payment, it was 25 cents short, I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt.
This just doesn't seem right. So, of course, we'll stay on top of it for you. I'm 5 on your side investigator, Jonathan Walsh.
Jerome contacted Legal Aid Society of Cleveland. At first, it said it couldn't help him, but after 5 on your side investigators called and explained his case, we're told that Legal Aid is taking a second look and it can probably get involved.